Welcome to our timesheet analysis tutorial. Today we will analyze the work hours of NY Construction's limited workers. A hypothetical New York-based construction company, with many projects around the city, having 55 total workers. So stay tuned and let's start our tutorial. We have data in MS Excel file. The first sheet contains the list of projects by their IDs and their locations. The second sheet contains the list of project categories. In the third sheet, we have the list of all 55 workers. Workers can be assigned to any project within the city of New York. And finally, we have the timesheet data of workers, which contain information about their work hours and overtime. We will start our project by importing all the data from MS Excel file using the Get Data feature. Import all four tables to your Power BI desktop application. Make sure all tables and their fields are available in the data pane. Create three pages in your Power BI file and rename them to Projects, Employees, and Timesheet. Now, go to the model view and create relationship among tables. Remove the auto-generated links first. Connect the Project Categories table to the Projects table and set the cross-filter direction to both. Connect the Employees table to the Timesheet table, again setting the cross-filter direction to both. And in the same way, connect the Projects table to the Timesheet table as well. Now, go back to the report view. Open the Projects page and insert a text box visual. Add a title to your dashboard with larger font size and make it bold as well. Insert a blank button to your dashboard. Place this button at the top right corner of the dashboard. Change the shape style of this button to rounded tab, both tops. Turn on the text property and add timesheet to text, using same font size as dashboard title. Create two copies of this button and place them to the left side of the existing button. Change their text to projects and employees, respectively. Google for clock Unicode symbol and copy it. Paste it in the timesheet button text. This will make the button look much better. Google for worker Unicode symbol and copy it as well. Paste the worker Unicode symbol inside the text of employees button. Change the button text and the page title from employees to workers. Finally, search for construction Unicode symbol and copy it. Paste this symbol inside the text of projects button. Insert a line shape to your dashboard and place it below the navigation buttons and the title. Change the line width to 3px by changing the border width property. And change the line color to black. Copy the title and buttons to all other pages as well, changing the title to respective page names. Add the project category field to the dashboard and convert it into a slicer. Insert a card visual and add the ID field from employees as count to the card visual. Rename the file from count of ID to number of workers. And place the visual here. Copy the card visual and replace the ID field with the hours worked field from timesheet table. Again, create a copy of the card visual and replace the hour worked field with the regular hours field from timesheet table. Create another copy of the card visual and this time replace the regular hours field with the overtime hours field. Arrange and place all cards and slicers properly and in symmetrical way. To make the tutorial short and to the point, we are fast-forwarding various parts of the video. Please use pause button if we are too fast. Insert a map chart to your dashboard and add the location field from projects to the map chart. Now, we can see the locations of all projects on a map. Change the map style according to your requirement or your liking. The location indicators are more visible on a light or gray scale map. Therefore, we will choose one of those. Select All Visuals and turn on Visual Borders. Also set the rounded corners to 5px or whatever you prefer. Arrange and place visuals nicely on the dashboard. One of the location is wrongly pinned, which needs to be corrected. To do that, we will open the Excel file. In the Excel file, we will add further detail to the location to avoid confusion with similar location. After making changes, save the file and go back to Power BI. Whenever you make changes to the source data, refresh the Power BI file, and the data will be updated here as well. Power BI always confuses locations when they have similar names, so watch out for that. And after refresh, the location has been updated. Now, go to the Workers page and add a slicer to the dashboard. Add the Employee Name field to the Slicer Visual. Change the slicer style to drop down from slicer settings. Add another slicer to your dashboard and add the Workweek field to this slicer. Change the slicer style to a vertical list. Place this slicer below the other slicer in vertical form. Copy card visuals from Projects page and paste them here. Place these cards right next to the Workweek slicer vertically. Create another card visual by copying one of the existing ones. Replace the data field with break hours. Add a map visual to this dashboard. Place this visual at the right side. Add the location field to the map visual. And change its style to light or gray scale from settings. Now select all visuals on this page and turn on visual borders. Also set the rounded corners to your taste. Now you can see which worker worked in which areas during a specific work week along with their work hour details. Now, let's move to the timesheet page and add a slicer to the dashboard. Add the year and quarter fields from the date hierarchy and place the slicer at the top left corner of the dashboard. Add a line and column chart to this dashboard and place it next to the slicer visual. Add the regular hours field to the column y-axis and the overtime and break hours fields to the line y-axis. Go to the table view and add a new column to the timesheet table. Let's call it week number. Calculate the week number from the work week column using the week number function. Now, go back to the report view and add this field to the x-axis of the line and column chart. Great, now we can see weekly work hours during a quarter. Add another slicer to the dashboard and add the employee name field from employees table to this slicer. Insert a pie chart to this dashboard and add the hours worked as values and the location field as legend to the pie chart. Copy this chart and place it next to the existing one. Replace the location field with the category field as legend. Copy hours worked and overtime hours visuals from the workers page and place them here at the bottom right corner. Select all visuals and turn on their visual borders and set their rounded corners to 5px as well. Properly place all visuals on the dashboard in symmetrical way. Finally, add actions to the navigation buttons above. Select the button and turn on its action option. Then select page navigation from action type drop-down. Then select the target page from destination drop-down. Repeat these steps for all buttons on all pages, except the buttons pertaining to the same page they're placed on. Obviously, they do not require any action, because they are already placed on their target page. After mapping navigation buttons, check them by navigating to their target pages. And our timesheet analysis is now complete. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.